Today, I'm going to talk about the BlackBerry Z10. Now, before we're going to continue this video, I want you to subscribe to my channel. Hit the little notifying bell. It's mandatory, otherwise you won't get no updates whenever I upload a video. And leave this video a like, because this is a very nice little video that will give you information about the BlackBerry Z10 in 2018. Welcome back. So, I got this BlackBerry yesterday. I got it very, very cheap. This phone is from 2013 and it runs the latest BlackBerry OS that is available for this device. I think that's 10.3 point something. I can tell you that these last 24 hours, well, 12 hours, I've been playing a lot with this phone. What did I discover? Well, I discovered that it's a very, very nice phone. If you take a look at the phone, it's a very, very lovely phone. You see that? And this phone got, of course, the iOS looks. How can it else be? It's a very lovely phone that also will give you a nice user experience. But is it still any good? And why would you even want a BlackBerry in 2018? Well, probably because you found one cheap just like me and you were like, let me take a look into it, and you never knew about BlackBerry, and you know that the previous president of the United States was also using BlackBerry, probably not this one, but it was as well a BlackBerry. And the BlackBerry OS is a special kind of OS. What I found out, it deals totally different with security. As you can see, I do have this launcher here, this iOS launcher, but you see no phone. You see, the phone is not supported by this launcher. Do you want to make a phone call? You will have to go to the official launcher of BlackBerry. And why was that done? I think it was done to protect you from some launcher that will go and use and call your phone, and you know, the launcher has no access to the phone. So that's kind of cool. I also found out that this operating system is dealing totally different with things. And in 2018, I could download everything from the net. It behaves as a grown-up phone on the net. That, well, this thing is from 2013, it came together with the iPhone 5. I think at that time, from the iPhone 5, it came out. We're now at iPhone 10, so just look at how many years this is. But this phone is reacting fantastically good. And what do I like about this phone? Well, besides the security that I like from this phone, the way it works and the way it deals with the BlackBerry OS and the built-in Android. Because yes, this thing has a built-in Android app player. I think BlackBerry should update it to app player 7.12. And BlackBerry should keep working on the BlackBerry OS. Because I'm going to show you something. We're going to jump into this phone. But first, I want to talk about my experience until now. You know, I know a lot about iOS. I know a lot about Android, Windows phones. But I didn't know too much about BlackBerry yet. So, playing with this device, I found out that thanks to the built-in Android app player, I could easily download my favorite theme. I could get my APK pure thingy on here to download apps. The APK pure, you see the icon there? I can with that app, I can download, was it here? Yes, the A that you see here. With this app, I can download almost every app that I kinda need. I also pushed this market to my mods, and you already, my Pukram family, they already know this app store. It's called APK Pure. I just love it. These guys, they kind of take care of the apps that are being posted out there, and the apps are clean. And some of them even come without advertisement. So I really appreciate that. I did try to install the Play Store. There is a possibility to install Google Play Store account and services onto the phone. I did it, but the Google Play Store, the moment I wanted to download something, it said Google Play Store stopped. So, in fact, I did not need that all, so I deleted it again and saved myself up at least 200 megabytes. And what can I say? The APK Pure is also giving me WhatsApp. WhatsApp runs fantastically good on this device. It's registered. We're gonna do a live show, and then you can call me on this phone, and we're gonna be live in the show, and then we can talk about things, and you can ask questions live, and you will be in the video. So WhatsApp is working, and that is for today very important. Also, another thing is, if you're in some app, you see this is WhatsApp, and here you're gonna swipe up. I think the iPhone 10 thing was, in fact, by an idea of BlackBerry, because BlackBerry, you also swipe up like that. But the coolest of that, it will let you close the apps that are open. You immediately see how many apps you have open, so you always keep the power of the phone. And you see this launcher that you're seeing, we can also just swipe it up. And now, like this, we are in the official launcher. You see, with the phone and with all the other apps that you don't see in the launcher that you're running on top of the system. So I've been playing a bit with it, and I also installed my favorite tools, such as this ham radio here. This is brand new. I'm gonna make a ham rum as well. Ham rum, for people that love transmitting and using their device as a ham radio to listen out to amateurs on the USB band and the SSB band and these things. So I will have to show you how this works. Let me show you that. No, I don't want to accept default configuration. Load, yes. Okay, save default configuration, start. Okay, and this is how it looks. You see that? That's a ham radio. Here you turn it on by long press. It's gonna go on, I think. Yes, it's... Let me see. Please connect USB CAT cable. Okay, this you can also connect a CAT cable to it. So you can do fantastic, ham radio experience on this thing, if you like it. But in fact, it's not about that. I just wanted to show you the phone. So let me put you on the tripod so we can take a better look at what this phone is. And let me show you some benefit that this phone has that none of the other phones have, okay? If you're somebody that loves music, then the BlackBerry phone is one that you should take a look at. This Set 10, I got it very, very cheap. People are scared to ask money for it because everything is Android and iOS, you know, and even old iPhone 4s are being sold for 20 euros, you know? So this phone, I can tell you, it has hidden features. Let me first tell you about the cam. The cam here that you see is a full HD cam. The front cam is 720p, okay? And this camera, my friends, it's a camera that is giving you the possibility to make a picture in full dark. Well, full dark, it's not so dark, but look at the picture. And the picture will look just like that, you know, if you're gonna make it like at night and while you're, you know, making a picture of a dark situation, you must use the flash. If you don't use the flash, of course, it will not look good. So I saw a review, somebody was saying, yeah, the cam, you must blah, blah, but probably he did not use the flash, I'm not sure. But with flash, this thing is just, it's just great. The camera, it records fantastic, really fantastic. And the coolest of it is, and that's what I really love from BlackBerry. Look at this picture, man. Look at this picture. What I really love from BlackBerry, that is that they have an app called Story Maker. It has the same star as the iMovie. It is as if they want to say, hey, we are a sort of, you know. And if you're gonna start it up, you can add a video to the storyboard, for instance this one, and then you say next, and then here you have all sorts of, yeah, well, I'm not even sure if these are themes. Oh yeah, here you can see that you can add music. Now this music will of course not be copyright free, I think, so I would not use any music. You don't have to put any music, just hit next. And then up here you see a little storyboard, you know, that you can change. You can give a name to the video, etc. Blah, 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 you know. And then you go finish. And then it's going to load the video. And this is effect how it's going to become. You see? The titles you can change.
Verplichtingen aanstellen, omdat het van de overheid is.
Okay, this is about NPO, but up here you can also go to settings, yeah, and then you can go to story settings, all the way at the bottom, and then you can say, here it's saying shorten videos automatically, no, and now you will have the complete video that you recorded with, at the front, you know, some board that is gonna say the name of the video and what it's about. Very simple, but then, you know, you're gonna get the video, and at the end you're also gonna get, you know, blah blah blah, buy, etc. You can put whatever you want, subscribe, like, you know, all these things. So when I saw that and I rendered the project, it was a 13 minutes video. And it took about 10 minutes to render that 13 minutes video with the dual core processor that this thing has. I immediately saw a value of this phone. No watermark, no nada. It will make a beautiful render of the project, and you can even select some effects, put it in black and white, or, you know, give it some chroma color, or you can do all sorts of little things that I saw. So, my experience as a critical phone user was immediately nice. I felt in love with this device, and I'm gonna advise BlackBerry. This is for the company BlackBerry. You guys, you're creating safe phones. That was always your policy. Good phones, safe phones. We, you know, BlackBerry OS. Now the public was complaining. Yeah, not so much apps. And most apps you must pay. So people tried to run Android on BlackBerry OS in the past, when we had this playbook. There was a BlackBerry OS that could run Android apps. Not so good, and there was a complete hassle. You had to do all sorts of little things, but some guys managed to run Android apps. With the Z10, things changed. BlackBerry said, hey, I don't want all these complaints anymore. You know what? We're going to build in an app player. Then all these people, you know, they can as well run, but we're going to make sure that the system is not going to interfere with the security of Black, so it's gonna run like on top, but for the main and important functions, you will still have to go to the official BlackBerry home screen. So, to BlackBerry, I want to say that that was a fantastic good move, because even I, thanks to that, got a kind of, immediately I felt in love with the device. Also, I love the quality of the camera. I love the fact that the thing has a built-in kind of video editor. You know, I found some apps that I installed from the BlackBerry Play Store, or however you call it. A very sweet recorder here. With this thing, you can record music. And this thing, it records nice. It does not record in WAV or MP3. It's making, I think, ACC files or so. So that is, yeah, a little bit sad. I did not find a good, but I think you can also use some Android app, because that is where Android comes in now, because we also can run Android apps on this thing. So I got my APK store here. So here I can go and get any Android app that is available for this device. There you go. I'm in my APK store, and then I'm gonna select, I'm gonna look for what's it called again? Let me see. Oh, it's on that phone. I think it's Sound Record Pro also. Sound Record Pro. Let me see if it's there. It looks a little bit like this one. Yeah, try any one of them and see which one will give you high quality recordings. You probably already have some app that you know that you're already using. If you're an Android user, go ahead and download it. We can just go for this one, voice recorder, this one here. It's 6 megabytes, and let me show you how it works. It's gonna download it. This is really cool, eh? Because now you have an Android to play with. Because in fact, you can just play with this Android and run the apps. I've been listening to Live ATC Radio whole night long, and I didn't get any banner, not even one. But that's because of the app, great app. And up here we say accept, and now we're installing an Android app on this thing. It's also saying that this, you know, could not maybe work the way as expected, but you know, it will really do its best to work as good as it can. And here we have the recorder that is loading up now. Not sure if it will be able to get access to the microphone, but it should. I see no reason why it should not. And if you have that apps are opening a little bit slow, just close one app and go back to the app. It's very simple, slide up and just load it again. And I'm not sure at this case if it's gonna load. I never used this app yet. And what I found out, if it's not running, just close the app and reopen it again. Here. Boom, you see that? And it says, beoordeel me met 5 sterren. I'm gonna say no thank you for now. Okay, and here we have a beautiful recorder. So let's look into the settings. And in the settings we can say opname kwaliteit, MP3 and OGG. You see that? We leave it nice on MP3. And opname kwaliteit, the recording quality, yeah, we can set it here to several settings. We're gonna say the best quality. You see that on top? I just selected best quality. So now I think we can go one back here. Oh, I'm sorry about that. What should I do? Oh, go back one here. How do I record? Well, I'm just gonna... I don't know what I did. So let's do it again. We're gonna open the app. There it is. The sound record. Sound recorder. And there it is. We already set it, the settings. So now we can go ahead and record. See if it works. Is it working? I see it working. Yes, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I'm stopping the recording. Stop. Oh, I can pause the recording. So when you want to stop the recording, you must stop it here, I think. It really wants to face you before it listens. This is very... If you don't look at the device, it will not accept finger touches. Eh? So that is also very apart. Mm-hmm. So opnameless, here we just created this. Let's listen to it, if it works. If it...
It seems working.
It's working.
Yes, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Stop. Oh, I can pause the recording. So when you want to stop the recording, you must stop it here.
Fantastic. So we learned that Android apps will fix everything that BlackBerry is kind of missing out there. So the Set 10 is effect, how can we call this? I think we can call it a hybrid. This is a hybrid phone because it runs BlackBerry, but it also has Android built in. And let me show you how cool that is. If you're gonna go to the settings of the BlackBerry, I'm talking a lot about this phone. I know it's an old phone, but if you're gonna get it in 2018, you're gonna love it because you can do things with this phone that you cannot do with any other of these phones. Up here you can see these are the settings part. You see that this is the settings part. Here you can do all sorts of things. This is the settings part of BlackBerry. So now we're gonna go home. How do we do that? Oh yeah, of course. Swipe up and close. Now I'm gonna show you something. Now I'm gonna run my my iOS launcher. Nice, eh? The little Apple. And then up here we're gonna go to settings. And what do we see? Let me just swipe everything to the... What do we see? These are Android. This is Android settings. You see that? This is not amazing. So, in fact, you're having an Android and a BlackBerry system in one. So, yeah. Look at this. This is just Android settings. Go down here. Android 4.3. You see that? Saying Android 4.3. Crazy. So I'm totally in love with this device. Only the 4.3, I would love to see it Android 7. So I don't know if we can work on that maybe this year. You know, maybe some of you developers that know about these phones, you know, start working on an app player that we can update this app player in here. I don't know how close this operating system is. Probably it's not possible because the Apple and Apple operating system, but also the BlackBerry, they are closed systems that you cannot, in fact, enter. Well, I never tried yet and I never studied it yet. But what I can say about this phone until now is that it being hybrid and it giving me the satisfaction of being able to run the apps that I also run on my other phones, such as, you know, user apps, recorder, police scanner, Live ATC, video recording, video editing, you know. One thing I found out that was a little bit tricky to do, that was setting up your Gmail, but you can set up your Gmail with the mail built-in mail app that you have in here, and just go through the steps and just put in your email account, then it's gonna select know that it's Gmail, and then it will start downloading all your mails to your phone, so you're gonna have everything, all your information on your phone. So that is kind of cool. Okay, I use a special account for this phone to see how it's gonna behave as a phone. Of course, I don't have to tell you that all your accounts should have a two-step verification. We read in the news that only 10% of the Gmail users is actually using the two-step verification security. So yeah, all these things you of course must do, but I think the BlackBerry OS is, because it's being so close, it's a safe device still to use, especially if you're gonna use some VPN on this device, if you're working for some government organization. Because in fact, these phones were created for this phone was from a police officer. Officially, this phone was from a police officer. That's what the seller told me yesterday. So yeah, these phones are being used by people that are into security and don't want their information to leak. This is what it is. It's very nice, and because it can run your Android apps, you will have an experience that will really satisfy you. And especially listening and watching TV, etc. So I'm gonna get you on the tripod real fast so we can take a look at some more little things that I want to show you, because now I'm gonna show you a part in this phone that in fact none of the other phones have. They wish, and people are paying to get that on their phone at the others, but here it's completely free.
I know this is a nice and long weekend video about a phone that you guys don't see too much anymore these days. A beautiful phone that has a nice design that you can also replace the battery from. Yes, that's not a joke. Up here you can open the phone, and here you can see that we can insert a SIM card. There's a SIM card inside, and here we have a micro SD card from 32 gigabytes max that we can put in. So that's cool. I had no display protection when I got the phone. It had no display protection, so I got one for some phone that I had, and I measured it out. I cut out, you know, the parts that I think that I want to protect. As you can see, the camera, I did not I did not cover that one up, so it will still make beautiful videos with that, without some plastic being over it, you see. So yeah, the phone for these couple of bucks that I paid for it, it was so cheap that I could not refuse it. I was like, no, I'm gonna get it. I want to get to know what it is and why, you know. So to BlackBerry, I want to say, yo, you guys, you must continue this. You're stepping over to Android. Are you out of your mind? What you must do is keep BlackBerry OS and just add the player to it. You know? I mean, yeah, like, you're creating safe phones and then you're gonna put Android on the phones? Just because people complain and you want to get in, you want to be in some race? You must not be in a race. You must stand behind your product. This is your goal. This is the goal. BlackBerry OS, BlackBerry, yeah. And for those that are complaining and whining that want more apps, there you go. Go ahead and install any Android app on this thing, and it probably will work. So what is so cool? Now it comes, peeps. Now it comes. Are you ready? Most of you Android users didn't even know that this existed. Here you can see the BlackBerry Play Store. You also have an Amazon store. I'm not using that, you know. Me and Amazon, we don't deal with that. So up here you can go to the BlackBerry Play Store, And if you go ahead and, for instance, you type music, you're gonna find Music Finder, and you're gonna find music. As you can see, they are completely free. I install them. Here they are. Music Finder. So, what does your day look like? Let's just type some artist, Frank Sinatra. There he is. Boom. And here you can see, oh, sorry for that, baby. Here you can see a bunch of Frank Sinatra songs. You click play.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss.
Oh, so nice, huh? Oh, I'm so sad I can't play it. Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This was told by brother. You can't have one without the other. The best part of it is that you can download the song immediately. And then you just hit the little link there. And up here you just hit save. And there you go. And your song will be saved. And then after that you can play it offline. Beanie Man. So yeah, so that is kinda cool, huh? Is that not fantastic? So you can get each and every song that you want that exists in the world completely free here on your BlackBerry. Let's see if we can find Justin Bieber. Oh yeah, daar is hij, Justin Bieber met zijn getieter. I Can Fly, let's listen to it.
Never say never.
Wow. Beautiful. Great. Hey, tell me one phone that has this. None of your phones can do this.
As long as you love me.
Amazing. Just think of an artist. Call one more. Call an artist, Buck Darlington. No, I'm not in here. I must make sure I get in here. This is Sweet Caroline by Puck. Sweet Caroline. Bam, bam, bam. So that is nice, huh? You see that? Neil Diamond and all these artists. If you're gonna look for Neil Diamond, look a bunch of songs you're gonna find here, and you can download them all. Cracklin' Rosie song. I love this song. Amazing song. Then Mr. Bojangle, Mr. Bojangle. Hey! Hey! That's what I like about you! So you find all sorts of things here. But can we find reggae? Let's look for Gregory Isaacs. Gregory. Oh, I must type good. And this thing types so nice, huh? It types nicer than my Gregory Isaacs. There you go. Look at all these Gregory Isaacs songs that you can find here. Completely free, peeps. Mm. La da da da, cool down the place for me, little woman. Hey, I think all of you must run and go look the marketplaces to find a BlackBerry. A second-hand one. One that is running BlackBerry OS. Tell me where you can find this. This is amazing. Just because I fell in love on a Sunday morning. This is amazing. Wow. So, how about some reggae dubs? Can we find reggae dub? Reggae. And these are not songs that people are talking through it, huh? This is not radio. Reggae dub. Oh, Lucky Dubé. Let me see Lucky Dubé. Oh, look at these songs of Lucky Dubé, man. Look at that. Listen to the quality. It sounds great. I think if you connect some big speaker to this thing, maybe some streams have a lower quality. Some of them sound good. This is really amazing. So let's see if we can find some Hindi music. Shahrukh Shahrukh Khan. Shahrukh Khan. Let me see if Om Shanti. No. Let me see if I can find some Hindi. Because my Hindi people must also feel good, you know. These are my people, you know. Hindi, log in music. I don't know all these names, you know. I don't know names from, but Hindustani, what is this? Only one song. Nice. So yeah, how about Romania? This is Romanian edition. I think you need to know the names of the artists, and then you will find, I think, every song in here, and you can immediately download it. Let's look for Rita Marley. Rita Marley, there she is. Look at that. Music. Good quality. Nice. So, yeah, I showed you already. You can go look and find your own music whenever you also got your first BlackBerry, if you never had one before. And if you still have one, then probably I don't have to tell you whatever you can do with it. Here, this is a music player. This one was from BlackBerry itself, so yeah, it plays good. Oh, that was my recording.
Yes, testing. 1, 2, 3, 4.
You hear that? So this device is a little nice and lovely device that will also give you, of course, maps. You also have maps. I think it should find my location. Ik ga akkoord. And probably the maps does not look so new as the and so great as the ones that we have. Well, it does not look bad. I don't see nothing bad here. Rotterdam. And then Voermanweg. My cousin lives there. My brother from another mother. So this all is kind of working. You can see the complete location of where I live, including my city, and by zooming, pinching out, you can get the complete card of the Netherlands. So it looks good. I think it looks fine. Well done. Thumbs up. Great that it's available. And boom, that's the way how you close an app. So now we have no running apps open, and that makes the device always running very, very well. Because you're gonna see, if you're gonna have some open, then it sometimes wants to, you know, kind of be a little bit slow with opening apps. This is an Android app that we also use in our how you call it, ROMs and mods. And this is, of course, the Chicago police. This is the city of Bob. You see that? So this works great. I let it play whole night. When I woke up this morning, it was still playing. So it's not like stopping and, yeah, this app has stopped. You know, nothing like that. I couldn't find anything that was giving me that these kinds of messages. You have a nice clock, of course. Look at that. Tell me a clock that looks so nice. Hey. So, yeah, BlackBerry, I don't know, maybe, yeah, the guy there lost trust of the operating system itself, the BlackBerry operating system, but it's very nice, it's very lovely, it's stable, it will let you run Android at the side, so it's Android and a BlackBerry device, but it's a BlackBerry device with Android built in, let's call it that way, okay? You can get each and every app that you want, and it might work if it works on 4.3. Yeah, so that is, yeah, if the app was made for Android 5 and higher, then it won't work, of course, logisch toch? But here you can see WhatsApp is there. We have a YouTube player. We cannot have the official YouTube because we have no Google Play service installed, and in fact there is no good Google Play service available. Well, it installs and it will do the account thing, but when you're gonna open Play Store, then it says failed. If you open YouTube, it says Google service is not installed on this device, it's not available for this device, so you can forget about it. But you can use alternative apps. This is mobile YouTube, will work fine. Oh no, this is to upload a video to YouTube. So if you have an account, you put the account in here, you can upload videos straight from this phone to YouTube. Completely free. You see that? And if you get the BlackBerry card, then probably you're gonna buy these 179 apps and then 199 apps that are out there in the place in the BlackBerry store that are kinda looking good and promising. There's also a Gmail app that you can buy for 175. So I want the development to continue. I think the development on the operating system, security updates and update of the system as well, must continue there, BlackBerry. Don't stop it. You are idiots if you're gonna stop it. This is beautiful operating system. Continue with this and make the app player update the app player. Bring that part of Android 7.12 that you're putting in your other phones, bring that part in here. That's how you should do it. And make sure that this phone, this Z10, stays alive, because it's a good phone, nice phone to use, great to put in your pocket, get a nice cover for it, although this thing won't slip out of your hands, even if your hands are wet. It feels, yeah, very very nice. It feels great in your hand. You feel that this is quality. Okay? So I think this is the most how can you say that? Strangest review probably that you saw of this phone in 2018 and maybe even to 2017 and 2016. But I tell you, yeah, if you know Android, then you're gonna love this, okay? Because this phone is dealing totally different with everything. And at this moment, no Android app is running. If it was running, then it would be here. You would see it here. And then you could just, you know. So anything that you're starting up, everything that you're starting up, you can, boom, close easily. You see that? And I had a complaint over the scanner radio that it was stopped. So let's see what is happening there. Just needed a little reboot. You see that? So don't get nervous when it's saying it stopped. That was because some other app. This is still an emulator. It's a player. It's an Android app player that is built in. So don't go putting your expectations too high. But as you can see, a combination of Android and the BlackBerry apps will let you come, you know, a whole way. Some reviews that I'm gonna create soon will be made with this phone, because I love the way it renders the video. It does it very, very fast for this dual core. What is it? 1.3 gigahertz. I don't even know what kind of processor this thing have. Maybe we can see it in here. Let's take a look, real quick look. App here, opslag, info. OS en toestelnaam. This is the BlackBerry ID pugdarlington@gmail.com. And you can see the serial number and algemeen the OS. Let's look at the OS. Here you can see this is the OS, peeps. It's version 10.3.3 build 1435. OS version. Oh no, that's the software version. Oh, I missed that there. What was it saying? OS. Build ID 1930-35. Version cryptography kernel 5 blah blah blah. Radio versie, WebKit versie, browser versie, firmware, NFC blah blah. Open NFC, whatever that is. And BlackBerry 10 software version. This is the version. And this is the OS build. 10.3.3.2163. So yeah, here you can select as well your payments, whatever you want to do. So you're gonna set up your BlackBerry ID to do that. You even have an assistant, but then you must speak French. Oh, no, you can put it to... Oh, I never saw this part of the assistant that you can put it to English. I thought I had to speak French to it. You see, you also have an assistant. Oh, you may not say bad words. I don't like it to listen. I want to say whatever I want. So, here, we can just slide up again. And go find your thingy, and that you find in here. How far is it from Earth to the Moon? It understood me. It's thinking.
The distance from the Earth to the Moon is about 396,904 kilometers.
Wow, that's well done. What is the name of the President of the United States?
Searching the internet for what's the name of the President of the United States.
It doesn't know. It doesn't know. Oh my God. Okay. Who is Barack Obama?
Style box, B-R-A-H-K Hussein Obama M. Font Slant, italic semicolon, born August 4, 1961, is an American politician who served as the 44th President of the United States from 2009 to 2017. He is the first African American to have served as President. He previously served in the U.S. Senate representing Illinois.
Oh, very nice. Let me see if his nose. Oh, it's stuck. Oh boy. Who is Siri?
Searching the internet for who is Siri.
Who is Siri? Nice. Where can I find Paramaribo? It really understands good.
Here are the results for Paramaribo. Which one would you like to choose?
I would like to choose Paramaribo. Nice, huh? Never mind. Let's ask her one more thing. What shall we ask her? Who is the beautiful, most beautiful woman in the world?
Searching the internet for who is the beautiful, most beautiful woman in the world.
Okay, let me see if it can tell. Please tell me a story.
The following info was found.
Tell me a story. Perry Como? Also, what's the weather in my city, Baya?
Unable to find that location. Specify a different location.
Thank you very much.
Unable to find that location. Specify a different location.
I like it. I like this thing. It's not too intelligent. It's not too dumb. It's fantastic. Wow. Just think of what these guys already had in 2013. When did we get Siri? Oh, we got Siri with the iPhone 4S, right? So in fact, Siri was before this thing. Yeah. And this thing can also run Google thingy. Oh, you say that? Google, hello, Google. Or what's up, Google, however you say that. It can also run it, but I think it's too big. So I'm happy with this. This is just fine. You know? Tja. Beautiful device, huh? Amazing. And also the fact that you can get so many apps. The MIUI. Launcher. Boom. See that? Amazing, huh? So, yeah, what can I say? With the BlackBerry, you have, in fact, two worlds in one. And you also have a device that will protect you kind of good, I think. So let me know in the comments if I said anything wrong about, you know, security, that this phone is still very well to use in 2018. I think it's better than many phones we know and that are even being sold in the store at this moment. Just because of the OS and the way how it deals with things. The 4.4.2 or the 4.3 Android emulator or player. Yeah, how can I say? That effect is the only weak part of the system. And yeah, using certain Android apps, the wrong ones, might, you know, also infect that Android there. So I think it's also good to get something like Bitdefender, the virus scanner that we also, you know, that we use that for the Android apps that we're downloading. Because if we don't, Bitdefender, I think if we don't, then we might mess up the system, the Android app store, app player, I mean. So we're just gonna get the mobile security there. It's 9 megabytes. And I didn't even check if it's from Bitdefender itself. Let's first take a look who posted this thing. It was faster than me. I think it's okay. The inspection is, you know, is niet bekend. Dat deze app malware bevat. It says it's not known that this app has malware. So the BlackBerry Guardian in fact checked the app. You should read this all, okay? Then you can understand. So there's Black Bitdefender. So yeah, it's saying there that by using the Play Store, you know, you might infect the system with apps that are not good. They cannot guarantee for these apps that they are all good. So that's why we must do this. This what I'm doing is kind of mandatory to do. What is this? No, I don't want this. Why I must log in? What happened to my Bitdefender? This is not my Bitdefender. Now yeah, I'm gonna play with that myself, peeps. Deleting an app is really easy, just boop, and then it's gone. You see that? So I'm gonna check out what's wrong with the Bitdefender. I'm gonna get my own. The version that we also use, the free version. This is, I think, registered version, I don't know. So that's it. I think the BlackBerry is a fantastic phone and a fantastic device. And it's very sad that BlackBerry is now creating Android devices and that they don't and did not stick to their roots. Because that is what they should do. Get back to their roots and do what they are good into. And that is building the BlackBerry OS and bring it to BlackBerry OS 11. I'll be praying for it.
That's right. We will be praying for BlackBerry, that somebody there at BlackBerry will get back to their senses and immediately go back to work to continue long-term support for these phones. Not for this phone because I have it, just because I think BlackBerry is a great OS and I will keep supporting it here on my channel. I will keep talking about it. I will keep showing beautiful things that I'm gonna do with this phone. And then you one day will look on the marketplace and you're gonna see some Z10 that is being sold for 15 euros or $15 or $10, or maybe you can get it completely free from somebody. You know, then you're not gonna complain and say, oh, it's not Android, it's not iOS, I don't want it. Because now you know that besides you're gonna have a great video camera, you're gonna have a built-in video editor, you're gonna have a built-in music getter for you, so you can listen to free music. Okay, completely free, you don't have to nada, just download and you will have the music on your phone. So these are fantastic things of BlackBerry. And besides, I think that the quality of the device looks really nice. I love the way it looks, the way it feels. It's not 5-inch screen, this is only 4.2-inch screen, but it's fine. I don't feel that this is a small phone. And beside my iOS phone, this phone will be my second phone to use. So you know that I also inserted a special WhatsApp number. And when we're gonna do live shows, you can call me on that WhatsApp number. Some of you will get that number and then you're gonna be with me in the show. And then we can talk to the viewers and do nice little live shows while, you know, talking and bringing you as well into the conversation. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video about the BlackBerry Z10. Probably it's the longest one here on YouTube, and probably it's the one that will let you feel that you're missing out if you don't have the BlackBerry phone with the BlackBerry OS. the one that can run Android and BlackBerry. And on the other side, I'm gonna say to BlackBerry, BlackBerry, reconsider. Reconsider the shoe that you are throwing away. Think about it, okay? Think about it. I love this OS. I want it to stay, and I want you guys to work on it and keep continuing it. And your next phone will be a BlackBerry phone again with the Android 7.12 APK player inside, if that's what you wish. And if the buyer don't want that, then you're gonna have two phones, one only BlackBerry without Android and one with BlackBerry and the built-in app player of Android. It's just a matter of software. And if the people want the Android thing, then they only have to go to your website and download the right version for their phone with the built-in app player. That's how it should be. Don't go into a world that you don't understand and that was not yours. Okay, BlackBerry. That is my tip for BlackBerry. And to my BlackBerry users, I say thumbs up. Now I understand why you're still on BlackBerry and why you still have this phone and why you're still using it on a daily basis. It looks just as sophisticated as any other expensive phone out there. So you won't feel that you're, you know, I think people that will see you using the BlackBerry will kind of respect you, because BlackBerry phones are very, very secure. They are very, very safe to use. So if that is not the case, I want to read all your comments right here. And I want to thank you for watching. If you liked this long review of this phone, I already told you, leave it a like, this video, subscribe to my channel, and then, I'm gonna see you in my next live show that will be later on this evening. But first, go and enjoy this one, because it's long enough, it's almost a live show. So I want to thank you once again for watching. Till my next video, and toodaloo.